Thank you, everyone, for coming. It's Friday afternoon, of course. That was a lovely lunch. Thank you, organizers. So my talk is going to be about the Sustainable Development Goals. So before the minister starts her talk, then that you have a good understanding of what the SDGs are. I'm from the United Nations Technology Innovation Lab, and I am the thematic lead in peace and security. So technology, digital technology, data management is vital to the United Nations, as it is to the globe. I just wanted to give you this quote from Resolution 68-20 from General Assembly, where the General Assembly of the United Nations recognizes the vital role that science, technology, and innovation, including environmentally sound technologies, can play in development and in facilitating efforts to address global challenges. Here is the United Nations Technological Innovation Lab. Our mission is to leverage emerging technologies to transform societies, nations, and humanity as a whole. We try to enable the United Nations to deliver on its mandates and lift up countries using technology for the future. Oh, and now I see that there's a great screen here, so I can actually look down rather than up. As you can see, the Finnish lab, which is the first one, was founded in 2018. And since then, the network has grown with India, Rwanda, Thailand, and another 4 labs coming this year, next year. The thematic areas, each lab has different themes. Finland has 4, and these are the thematic areas are always chosen by the host countries. So the state of Finland has chosen these 4 themes for us. The 4 themes are health, peace and security, my area, education, and circular economy. Typically, the host countries choose themes where they think that they will be somehow exceptionally, have something exceptional to bring to the world stage. However, we collaborate very closely with the other labs as well. So we have Malaysia, for example, with ecotourism, Egypt, which also has agriculture, India, which has agriculture, and that allows us to bring kind of global knowledge. But then to the Sustainable Development Goals. The Sustainable Development Goals are a hugely ambitious plan built on the Millennium Development Goals to eradicate extreme poverty, address inequality, tackle climate change, and leave no one behind by 2030. The goals, there are 17 of them. The first one is that there should be no poverty. Second one is zero hunger. Third one, good health and well-being. Fourth, quality education. Fifth, gender equality. Sixth, clean water and sanitation. Seven, affordable and clean energy. Eight, decent work and economic growth. 9, industry, innovation and infrastructure. 10, reduced inequalities. 11, sustainable cities and communities. 12, responsible consumption and production. 13, climate action, which is, of course, especially on our minds today. 14, life below water. 15, life on land. 16, peace, justice and strong institution. And 17, partnerships for the goals. And as you see this round symbol, the partnership building between different sectors of society is especially vital for achieving the Sustainable Development Goals. I have a little film which will hopefully start. The Sustainable Development Goals are aimed especially at trying to help those most vulnerable. And I would just like you all to remember that if we actually want to improve global averages, the way to do that easiest is to help the most vulnerable and those who have the least. We are entering the decade of delivery, and in terms of data and in my field, there are some questions. In peace and conflict area, we talk a lot about do no harm. So how can we ensure that when we are trying to do good, we don't accidentally do some harm? In terms of data, we need to collect it. We need to understand how the development goals are going forward. However, data can also be dangerous. I have a few quotes. Digital technology can both provide opportunity and accentuate inequality. Digital dividends coexist with digital divides, and digital divides, we know, are growing. Similarly, if we want to use digital technologies to improve life for everyone, we have to go about it consciously and deliberately, with civil society, companies, and governments recognizing their interdependence and working together. This is especially important if we are talking about the most vulnerable. For the decade of delivery, the United Nations has convened a high-level panel on digital cooperation, and there's now been published the report from the Age of Digital Interdependence. You can find this online easily. The five findings of the report are to build an inclusive digital economy and society, to develop human and institutional capacity, to protect human rights and human agency, promote digital trust, security and stability, and foster global digital cooperation. But the next question is, well, how do we do this? How is this done? And here is where I would say that, well, you are also all responsible for the SDGs and for their fulfillment. And I hope that some of you will be inspired to use the vast knowledge that you have to answer the questions I have posed. Thank you very much.